It's to the capital we go now. The one team, one dream franchise, title town from last season, if it's in cricket parlance. And we're lucky enough to be joined from the Cricket Wellington offices by young Firebirds batsman and left arm spinner Rachin Ravindra. Rachin, welcome to the Cricket Nation cast.
Hey, thanks, Willie. Thanks for having me.
It's great to have you on. You know, I know you're probably pulling yourself away from the basketball, which I understand you've been spending most of your preseason on. How are things in the capital?
Yeah, it's been all good. It's been a nice little start to the preseason training and everything. Everyone's getting into it, both Firebirds and Blaze, and you know, we've just got like a culture session coming up and stuff. So it's all kind of going full steam ahead at the moment.
Full steam ahead, as is the hairdo at the moment, sort of growing out the app intentionally, or is that just sort of an off season?
Talk to me. I think it always grows out quite out of control and it gets a bit curly. So I think I'll just rock with it, not shave it off for the next 2 months and see what happens.
Love it. That young man swag. Let's talk about, I suppose we can cover off last season to begin with. Three trophies for Wellington. You did the double in the Dream 11 Super Smash. Just what was your memories of that fantastic day with the Blaze and then yourself, the Firebirds, following it up with two titles in one day with a great crowd there at the Basin?
Yeah, I think it was probably one of the most special days of cricket I've ever been involved in. I think obviously the Blaze being the trailblazers for the whole entire competition, just in terms of the way they dominated throughout, and it kind of showed in the final as well. And it just really, I guess, inspired us to keep pushing on and be better as a unit. But yeah, that day was incredible. I think just like it was a big crowd, and obviously to see them get up in emphatic fashion and then us follow up, like it was amazing to have like both teams in the changing room, both sets of staff, all Cricket Wellington staff there just enjoying what it was like a special day.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And then of course the Firebirds, you went on to claim the Plunkett Shield, the 4-day competition, which obviously was cut short by a few rounds, but a fantastic campaign for you guys there in the Whites.
Yeah, it was amazing. I think like winning the Plunkett Shield is probably one of the more rewarding things, especially in domestic cricket. I think you play 4-day cricket, it can be such a grind sometimes, and I think as a very rewarding at the end of the day, you know. But yeah, like if you can spend overs and overs in the field, you can nick off early and just watch. But that's why I think it was so good, you know, winning that.
You mentioned the grind. I mean, you're only 20, mate. I think you're into your third full season now. Yeah, how are you enjoying the grind and the different formats and the different challenges?
Oh, I think it's been amazing being able to sort of do it all going into my third full-time year. I think, like, everyone in Wellington, like, the culture we have here is quite welcoming and, you know, very comfortable. You know, it's always nice to see the lads every other day, and we always have banter. And then, like, I think we bond well as a unit, and I think we bond well as a whole sort of Cricket Wellington franchise, and it's just, you know, brilliant to be involved in.
Right, let's get down to the nitty-gritty with the Firebirds this year. You've got a few newly contracted players, Jacob Buller, Troy Johnson, an off-season transfer from Auckland for Finn Allen, a few of your under-19 teammates there. How are they tracking?
Oh, they're awesome. I've played a lot of cricket with those guys, especially Troy. I went to school with him, and we played first level cricket since I was like 13 together. So it was awesome to see his progression and get a contract this year. And obviously played with Jacob and Finn in the World Cup in 2018, and Finn in the 2016 edition as well. So it's just awesome to see like how people have come sort of from different districts and how you manage to end up playing with each other even after an under-19 level. And obviously they're all very talented players, so it's just awesome to be involved in them and just learning and growing with each other.
Yeah, and a guy who a little bit later in his career has earned his first contract by the name of Michael Sneddon. That is, of course, the son of New Zealand great fast bowler and current New Zealand cricket employee and former CEO Martin Sneddon. 27 years of age, a pretty cool story getting his first contract. He's 6 foot plenty, so how do you like facing him in the net so far?
I love Sneddon. He's honestly one of the best blokes ever. And like, he's just such a nice guy. But facing him in the nets is always not nice because you go forward and it hits your stickers. It's pretty uncomfortable. But I'm so stoked for Sneds.
Looking through the rest, obviously, plenty of class batting with yourself, Rachin. A guy by the name of Devin Conway, who topped every single batting chart last season. Domestic player of the year 2 years in a row. The all-rounder Logan Van Beek, who had a fantastic super smash last season and starting the final with a couple of great grabs. Tommy Blundell, when he's back, will have the gloves, the bowling of Ollie Newton, And of course, the larger than life character, Hamish Bennett, he's going around for another season of bowling hard length, refereeing the touch games, I'm told, and doing Ray Warren impressions. Is that how you see it?
Yeah, that's how I see it. Like, obviously, all those guys are such leaders in our unit and provide valuable guidance to all us younger players and even to the senior players. But yeah, it's all touch rugby is all not necessarily my game, Willie, as I think you might imagine.
More of a b-baller, aren't you?
Yeah, I follow people a lot, but
cricketer.
Cricketer. But I just stand on the wing and see what happens. But Benny's always good value in those touch rugby games. It gets pretty heated sometimes, and there's a couple of little spots of niggle, but we end up coming strong through it.
Yeah, I'm told that he certainly rates himself as a potential future NRL referee. Let's get across to the Wellington Blaze, the ruthless Wellington Blaze, and when they've got all their White Ferns there, the likes of Divine, the Kerr sisters times two. Rachel Priest has stepped back this season, so I think Jess McFadden might get a chance there as the keeper. But there's a couple of youngsters on the scene as well, an 18-year-old by the name of Zara Jetley, and, of course, Beth Maloney as well. What can you tell us about them?
Yeah, I think I've seen Zara played a bit of Super Smash last year, and I think Beth has as well. And I think they're both exciting talents, like both 18, 19, I think, around that sort of age. And it's like awesome to see them also during the winter, putting them the time in the gym on Friday mornings, Friday evenings. And the Nets, I've seen them a lot, and it's just awesome to kind of see what the future holds for them as well. And it's great to see them working hard and hopefully contributing to winning trophies for the Blaze.
I mean, I think the hashtag down there is We Are Wellington. So that kind of one team mantra, it's probably not just a catchphrase for you guys. It seems like something you kind of live and breathe as a major association.
Yeah, I think the culture that we've built, well, that everyone's built in Wellington is just like everyone's together. That's togetherness. I think it's awesome to have, whether it's what the Firebirds or whether it's the Wellington A's, whether it's the Blaze, whether it's the staff. I think we all work together and have work on a common goal, which is obviously winning trophies. And I think that support system starts from even grassroots cricket and even our age group cricketers. But I think it's just amazing to see that sort of culture come through Cricket Wellington, which I'm not sure if it has been in the past, but right now I think it's looking pretty strong.
Absolutely. Seems like a good place to be. And of course, Cricket Wellington have waived the club registrations this season as well. So throwing that out to there. What's your club down there and how do they go, Rachin?
Yeah, so we're the Hutt District Cricket Club, where we won the club comp last year, PS Cup. So that was obviously huge. Everyone was fizzing. Yeah, it was the first time in a lot of years. I'm not even sure we've won that trophy before. But the way Cricket Wellington have done it, if they've done the top division of clubs, is it's split 6 and 6. So they've got two competitions for top club cricket. And it really encourages more Firebirds playing games and makes it a lot more competitive, which I think is brilliant, and bring the standard of club cricket higher and higher after every year.
Awesome. And obviously with COVID-19 and the pandemic and some tough times as well, choosing to waive the club registration for the fees will no doubt help the club scene.
Absolutely. I think that's an amazing initiative by Cricket Wellington. I think if the clubs can afford to get more players on the park, I think it's amazing to see more people get involved. And I think that will happen because of the result of these registration fees being waived.
Absolutely. Well, look, we're going to move further up the country now, but Rachin, we really appreciate you beaming in, coming into the Cricket Wellington offices ahead of training. We wish you, the Blaze, as well, all the best this season. And we can't wait to see you out on that park.
Thanks, Willie. Appreciate it. Thanks for having me.